Day 3. I was hoping to pair again today, but it sounds like Paul is out sick. Apparently with a pretty nasty headache. That guy eats too much junk food.
It looks like Dr. Day wants me to learn two concepts today, the type Boolean and something called a control structure. My notes from yesterday's meeting say that a Boolean is kind of like a light switch. It's either on or off. Guess that if I want a Boolean, I type Boolean. So B-O-O-L-E-A-N. If it is like before, I will then type the name of the variable and the equal sign. Let's call my Boolean Bob. Right, Bob the Boolean. Equal sign. Okay, but with numbers, I just typed a number value, and with text, I surrounded the characters I wanted with double quotes. With Booleans, it sounds like they only have two states, true and false. So let's type true without double quotes, and then output the value by doing output Bob. So Boolean Bob equals T-R-U-E, true. And let's output Bob. And you run it. Success! From here, it looks like I'm going to use my first control structure. In this case, something called an if statement. I don't know what that means exactly, but the word if seems to imply that when I pass something that is true, it will do one thing, but if it's false, it will do something else. This one is tricky enough that I'm going to grab some coffee, read up a little, and come back.
Where's my coffee mug?
All right, I think I have a better idea of how these if statements work now. Let's try adding one on to what we already have. I suspect the first thing I type is the word if. So, Boolean Bob equals true, output Bob. If, it says in my notes when using the word if, when I pass something true to it, like our Boolean Bob, it will execute code inside of its block, whatever that means. Let's see if it will accept Bob. Oh, and apparently, at the end of every if statement, we need to write the word end to indicate where it stops. So, if Bob, enter, end. If I run that, looks like nothing happened. It says Bob like before, but the if statement didn't do anything. Oh, I get it. So, if statements that result in true only execute code between the word if and the word end, but I didn't write any code in there. So, hypothetically, if I put a say statement inside the if, and Bob is true, it will execute. But if Bob is false, then it won't. Let's write an output statement inside of our if. Okay, say, double quote, con, double quote. Okay, so now I run it. Say statements are fun to play with. I wonder what happens if I change the value of Bob to false instead of true. So, Bob equals false, and then I'll run that. It didn't say anything, so it must have skipped the block of code. That's cool. It's almost as if the computer can make decisions for me. I wonder if I could write a computer program that could pick out the week's outfits.